here at IBM Booth MWC25 in Barcelona.
My name is Eoin Coughlan, and I'm the CTO for telecoms industry in IBM technology.
My name's Louis Powell. I work at the GSMA and I head up AI initiatives and technology.
We talk about AI for networks and also we talk about networks for AI. What will be the difference?
Maybe you want to start with that.
Sure, I'll cover the AI for network. So what we're seeing is that the first thing is there's no one model that solves your problem. So you need a multitude of models. You need to look at what kind of platform can I build that will allow me to use open source models, because we see so much innovation across all the models. We've seen DeepSeek come out and everybody's saying that looks really good. Why aren't we using this one? And in the next few months, we're going to see more. So similarly, when we're dealing with networks and we're looking at forecasting and predictions of networks, then we're using AI of time series models. We also have looked at network foundation models. So these are the types of models which are all going to be used in order to solve the problems we have in networks. So then we can contextualize them. Have one for radio, one for core, one for IP networks, one for transport, etc. We can help the enterprise business with their networks, all using AI that's trained on their specific types of data and using the best model for the job. That's how we build that up with an agentic model overall, choosing the right model, choosing the right AI, and getting the right input.
I think what we have to realize is the networks that are built today were built for dumb phones, dumb laptops, dumb house phones. They weren't built for modern smartphones, for what the future will be with AI agents, robotics, smart cameras. So networks for AI is that transition of building networks that are capable to supply smart devices that have compute, that take actions, and are autonomous to their user.
And that brings up the question about what investment the service providers should make.
It's important to have a platform that can work with open source models, with your own built models, with proprietary models. That flexibility is key, and access to open source gives you the innovation. When you look at the design, so when you have any of these use cases that you want to solve, you want to start with the design phase, which will normally start looking at the data. Data management becomes really important. Talk to operators who say, I don't use 80% of the data I save, or even more, right? And we see that lots of enterprise data isn't even used at all. So what we're suggesting is you have to look at the data management as a key component. So have you got the right observability layer, gathering the components of the network and all of the interesting interactions across the network, failures, etc., in order to find what the issues are? Do you then have the AI that discovers those and is able to present those with a possible fix, right? And then do you and create a service ticket for you if that's what you want? Or in an instance where you don't want to have a human in the loop, do you want to put in the automation in order to complete that closed loop? And then that's the piece that you want to get to. So that's your journey, but you have to have the data right. You have to have the flexible platform for AI, and you have to have the automation in order to deliver the changes that you want in the network.
And this is the role of IBM Consulting, right?
That's what we do in technology and in consulting in IBM, working with operators around the world to try to bring this change, transformation of the networks. And that's a journey that we've been on, but it's important that the automation pieces aren't all built on their own in isolation from each other, because at the end of the day, when you move up a layer, you've got a service and that spans the whole network, not just individual pieces. So that's the intelligence you want to build into it.
Louis, are communication service providers capitalizing on this transformation?
Yeah, we're seeing CSPs operate in various different ways. Some are building models. So we're seeing operators build large language models in languages such as Kazakhstan. So Veyon have built the first language LLM for Kazakh. We're also seeing operators build AI-first services. So LGU Plus, KDDI and others are building customer service agents for enterprises. In the middle, we're also seeing operators then provide AI edge. So they provide intelligent edge services to allow enterprises to get the best possible experience for their AI end products. And then also we're seeing a big investment in what we call AI factories. So GPUs as a service, building data warehouses to provide the raw compute that will be the backbone and more power AI.
What about the challenges communication service providers have or can have?
There's a number of challenges. One is moving towards cloud native. Once you move towards a cloud native structure, then you lower some of the barriers and you accelerate the different use cases that you want to roll out. That's a key challenge that they're overcoming. So you want to move it along in that direction. The other piece is the trust. So they want to be able to trust the models before they do automation, but they also have to trust the security on the data and the model itself. So there's a piece there around security that they need to take care of. And these types of barriers hold them back. And it's having that plan end to end and knowing where to start with and build that trust and build that momentum towards automation that you want to achieve.
How do you see adoption in our industry, in the telecom industry? What's your perspective?
Interestingly, IBM have recently published a report where it shows that telecom heavily adopted of AI. They've done it a long time on what we call predictive AI. It's been around for the last 15, 20 years, but they've also been very fast at adopting generative AI. It started off in customer service, front office, making sure that they can service their millions of users out of hours in different areas and different languages. Then they're focusing on their networks, as Eoin has been saying. And lastly, there's the opportunity for them to service their enterprise customers to making sure that those guys can adopt AI at the scale required to be competitive in other markets, such as automotive, manufacturing, aviation, etc., powered by our open APIs and our open gateway initiative.
And this report is IBM and GSMA, right? What can you say about the report?
Rewiring the telecom mindset, the idea being what areas do you need to invest in? Where do you need to focus? We looked at a number of different operators. We did a very large survey, and bringing that information together allows us to see that people are willing to invest now. So we're expecting that this year over last year would be like an increase of 20% in cloud expenditure, an increase of 19% in generative AI and 16% in traditional AI. So those types of advancements and investments are being made. Then what we're seeing is that there's a need across these operators to get new revenues. And of course, the new revenues are going to come from having the safe infrastructure in place with the automations and AI that make sure that the end-to-end services are good. And then it's about selling new services on top. And coming back to AI, they can sell AI as a service. So there's lots of opportunities. You talked about GPU as a service, AI as a service, the sustainability. These are all value adds that they can bring to their enterprise customers, adding to the connectivity revenue that they have today. And that gives them more value, more stickiness, I think, with their customers.
And the opportunity to differentiate themselves from others, right?
Exactly, yeah.
And to offer more services to others, right?
Yeah.
So. Is that happening right now?
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of adoption and very assertive movements towards AI, especially in China, APAC, the Middle East. They see it like we do, as AI is a huge opportunity. McKinsey have come out and said that, and others have come out and said that there's a huge opportunity for the telecoms industry of over 100 billion annually. And we think that's just the start. And I think what we're seeing is that's a huge growth opportunity that telcos haven't had for the last 10, 15 years. And so they are hungry, like we are, to help them adopt it.
Final words.
The report is available on our website. So if you want to go and see that report, please do. If you go to the IBM.com site, go to the IBV business value area. And in there, it's Rewiring the Telecom Mindset.
That sounds great. And thank you very much for your time. It was a wonderful conversation.
Yeah, thank you.
I'm clear.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.